In this tutorial, I'll show you what anti-aliasing is and how you can implement it in your OpenGL project. So you might have noticed that while horizontal and vertical edges look extremely crisp, diagonal edges tend to look a bit choppy, like a flight of stairs. This is due to how we display images on our screens. Since our displays are made out of a bunch of tiny squares, aka pixels, it is impossible to have a smooth line on the diagonal. But thankfully, we can fake smoothness by bleeding the color of an edge into the adjacent pixels, like so. Now, these jagged edges are called aliasing, and an anti-aliasing technique is what helps us get better edges. There are multiple techniques for anti-aliasing, each with their advantages and disadvantages. But today, I'll focus on MSAA, which stands for Multisampling Anti-Aliasing. So what does this multi-sampling refer to? Well, in the rasterization part of the pipeline, primitives are filled in. The way it is decided which pixels should be given a color and which should not is by checking if the sample point of a pixel, which is normally in the center of it, is inside the shape of the primitive. This means that if the sample point is even just slightly outside the triangle, it won't get sampled, even though you would think it should at least do so partially. Well, that is where MSAA comes in. As you might have guessed, this technique simply adds multiple sampling points so that a more accurate result can be reached. Here, for example, two of the four sampling points are inside the triangle, and so the color of that pixel will be somewhere between the color of the background and the color of the primitive. Now, let's actually implement this. Let's start off by creating a variable where we specify how many samples we desire. Now, if you don't have a frame buffer, then you can just give a window hint to GLFW, saying you want GLFW samples and then the number of samples you want, and then activate GL multisample. That was it for this tutorial, as... nah, I'm joking. But for real though, if you don't have a frame buffer, then that's all you have to do, you are done. If you do have a frame buffer, then you'll want to delete the GLFW part. Instead, you need to go to your frame buffer and replace all GLTexture2D with GLTexture2D multisample. Then replace GLTextImage2D with GLTextImage2D multisamples, plugging in the type of texture, the number of samples, the color format, the width, the height, and whether or not you want all samples to be in the exact same position in the pixels. Then for the render buffer object, we need to change from GL render buffer storage to GL render buffer storage multisample and add the number of samples we want. Now the problem is that we can't do any sort of post-processing on this frame buffer anymore since it has multisampling enabled. So to get around that, we'll need a normal frame buffer which we can post-process. This is just like the one I made in the frame buffer tutorial. Now in the main function, we want to make sure we first bind the multisampling FBO, clear the screen, clear the buffers, and enable depth testing. Then we draw everything we want to draw. After that, we bind the multisampling FBO as read-only and the post-processing FBO as draw-only. Now using GLBleed FrameBuffer, we'll resolve all the multi-sampling and copy the result onto the post-processing FBO. Now make sure you bind the default FrameBuffer and draw the FrameBuffer rectangle using the post-processing texture. Run the program and you'll see that the edges of primitives are a lot smoother and nicer. Just be aware that applying kernels in the post-processing will essentially override the anti-aliasing, and so you may end up with aliasing again. As for the number of samples you should use, I suggest using either 2, 4, or 8. You can go up to 16 and 32 on some GPUs, but the improvement over performance ratio is not worth it. That was it for this tutorial. As always, the source code and all resources used are in the description. Bye!